Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Hugging Face provides three ways to fine-tune a pretrained text classification model: Tensorflow Keras, PyTorch, and Transformer Trainer. Transformer Trainer is an API for feature-complete training in PyTorch without writing all the loops. This tutorial will use the Transformer Trainer to fine-tune a text classification model. We will talk about the following: how does transfer learning work? How to convert a Pandas dataframe into a Hugging Face dataset? How to tokenize text, load a pretrained model, set training arguments, and train a transfer learning model. How to make predictions and evaluate the model performance of a fine-tuned transfer learning model for text classification. How to save the model and reload the model. If you are interested in learning how to implement transfer learning using TensorFlow, please check out my previous tutorial, Customized Sentiment Analysis, Transfer Learning Using TensorFlow with Hugging Face. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Let's get started. In step 0, we will talk about how transfer learning works. Transfer learning is a machine learning technique that reuses a pretrained large deep learning model on a new task. It usually includes the following steps. 1. Select a pretrained model that is suitable for the new task. For example, if the new task includes text from different languages, a multi-language pretrained model needs to be selected. 2. Keep all the weights and biases from the pretrained model except for the output layer. This is because the output layer for the pretrained model is for the pretrained tasks, and it needs to be replaced with the new task. 3. Feed randomly initialize weights and biases into the new head of the new task. For a sentiment analysis transfer learning model on a pretrained BERT model, we will remove the head that classifies mask words and replace it with the two sentiment analysis labels, positive and negative. 4. Retrain the model for the new task with the new data, utilizing the pretrained weights and biases. Because the weights and biases store the knowledge learned from the pretrained model, the fine-tuned transfer learning model can build on that knowledge and does not need to learn from scratch. In step 1, we will install and import Python libraries. The link for the code is in the video description. Firstly, let's install transformers, datasets, and evaluate. After installing the Python packages, we will import the Python libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. TensorFlow and transformers are imported for modeling. Dataset is imported for the Hugging Face dataset format. Evaluate is imported for model performance evaluation. The second step is to download and read the dataset. The UCI Machine Learning Repository has the review data from three websites, mdb.com, amazon.com, and yelp.com. We will use the review data from amazon.com for this tutorial. Please follow these steps to download the data. 1. Go to the UCI Machine Learning Repository page for the sentiment analysis dataset. 2. Click Data Folder. 3. Download sentiment labeled sentences.zip. 4. Unzip sentiment labeled sentences.zip. 5. Copy the file Amazon cells labeled .txt to your project folder. Those who are using Google Colab for this analysis need to mount Google Drive to read the dataset. You can ignore the code below if you are not using Google Colab. Drive.mount is used to mount to the Google Drive so the Colab notebook can access the data on the Google Drive. os.chdir is used to change the default directory on Google Drive. I set the default directory to the folder where the review dataset is saved. pwd is used to print the current working directory. Please check out Google Colab tutorial for beginners for details about using Google Colab for data science projects. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Now let's read the data into a Pandas dataframe and see what the dataset looks like. The dataset has two columns. One column contains the reviews and the other column contains the sentiment label for the review. .info helps us to get information about the dataset. From the output, we can see that this dataset has 1,000 records and no missing data. The review column is the object type and the label column is the int64 type. The label value of 0 represents negative reviews and the label value of 1 represents positive reviews. The dataset has 500 positive reviews and 500 negative reviews. It is well balanced, so we can use accuracy as the metric to evaluate the model performance. In step 3, we will split the dataset and have 80% as the training dataset and 20% as the testing dataset. Using the sample method, we set frac equals 0.8, which randomly samples 80% of the data. Random state equals 42 ensures that the sampling result is reproducible. Dropping the trained data from the review dataset gives us the rest 20% of the data, which is our testing dataset. After the train test split, there are 800 reviews in the training dataset and 200 reviews in the testing dataset. In step 4, the training and the testing datasets will be converted from Pandas dataframe to Hugging Face dataset format. Hugging Face dataset objects are memory mapped on drive, so they are not limited by RAM memory, which is very helpful for processing large datasets. We use dataset from Pandas to convert a Pandas dataframe to a Hugging Face dataset. The length of the Hugging Face dataset is the same as the number of records in the Pandas dataframe. For example, there are 800 records in the Pandas dataframe for the training dataset, and the length of the converted Hugging Face dataset for the training dataset is 802. HG train data 0 gives us the first record in the Hugging Face dataset. It is a dictionary with three keys, review, label, and index level 0. Review is the variable name for the review text. The name is inherited from the column name of the Pandas dataframe. Label is the variable name for the sentiment of the review text. The name is inherited from the column name of the Pandas dataframe too. Index level 0 is an automatically generated field from the Pandas dataframe. It stores the index of the corresponding record. In this example, we can see that the review is thanks again to Amazon for having the things I need for a good price. The sentiment for the review is positive, and the index of this record is 521 in the Pandas dataframe. Checking the index 521 in the Pandas dataframe confirms the same information with Hugging Face dataset. In step 5, we will tokenize the review text using a tokenizer. A tokenizer converts text into numbers to use as the input of the NLP models. Each number represents a token, which can be a word, part of a word, punctuation, or special tokens. How the text is tokenized is determined by the Pretrained model. AutoTokenizer.from Pretrained BERT base case is used to download vocabulary from the Pretrained BERT base case model, meaning that the text will be tokenized like a BERT model. We can see that the tokenizer contains information such as model name, vocabulary size, max length, padding position, truncation position, and special tokens. There are 5 special tokens for the BERT model. Other models may have different special tokens. The tokens that are not part of the BERT model training dataset are unknown tokens. The unknown token is UNK and the ID for the unknown token is 100. The separator token is SEP and the ID for the separator token is 102. The pad token is PAD and the ID for the pad token is 0. The sentence level classification token is CLS and the ID for the classification token is 101. The mask token is mask and the ID for the mask token is 103. After downloading the model vocabulary, the method tokenizer is used to tokenize the review corpus. Max length indicates the maximum number of tokens kept for each document. If the document has more tokens than the max length, it will be truncated. If the document has less tokens than the max length, it will be padded with zeros. If max length is unset or set to none, the maximum length from the Pretrained model will be used. If the Pretrained model does not have a maximum length parameter, max length will be deactivated. Truncation controls how the token truncation is implemented. Truncation equals true indicates that the truncation length is the length specified by max length. If max length is not specified, the max length of the Pretrained model is used. Padding means adding zeros to shorter reviews in the dataset. The padding argument controls how padding is conducted. Padding equals true is the same as padding equals longest. It checks the longest sequence in the batch and pads zeros to that length. There is no padding if only one text document is provided. Padding equals max length pads to max length if it is specified. Otherwise, it pads to the maximum acceptable input length for the model. Padding equals false is the same as padding equals do not pad. It is the default, indicating that no padding is applied, so it can output a batch with sequences of different lengths. After tokenization, we can see that both the training and the testing dataset have 6 features: review, label, index level 0, input IDs, token type IDs, and attention mask. The number of rows is stored with numrows. Dataset train 0 gives us the content for the first record in the training dataset in a dictionary format. Review has the review text. The first review of the training dataset is thanks again to Amazon for having the things I need for a good price. Label is the label of the classification. The first record is a positive review, so the label is 1. Index level 0 is the index of the record. 521 means that the first record in the training dataset has the index 521 in the original Pandas dataframe. Input IDs are the IDs for the tokens. There are 32 token IDs because the max length is 32 for the tokenization. Token type IDs is also called segment IDs. BERT was trained on 2 tasks, masked language modeling and next sentence prediction. Token type IDs is for the next sentence prediction, where 2 sentences are used to predict whether the second sentence is the next sentence for the first one. The first sentence has all the tokens represented by zeros, and the second sentence has all the tokens represented by ones. Because our classification task does not have a second sentence, all the values for token type IDs are zeros. Attention mask indicates which token ID should get attention from the model, so the padding tokens are all zeros and other tokens are ones. In step 6, we will load the Pretrained model for sentiment analysis. Auto model for sequence classification loads the BERT model without the sequence classification head. The method from Pretrained loads the weights from the Pretrained model into the new model, so the weights in the new model are not randomly initialized. Note that the new weights for the new sequence classification head are going to be randomly initialized. BERT base case is the name of the pretrained model. We can change it to a different model based on the nature of the project. NumLabels indicates the number of classes. Our dataset has two classes, positive and negative, so NumLabels equals 2. In step 7, we will set the training arguments for the model. Hugging Face has 96 parameters for training arguments, which provides a lot of flexibility in fine-tuning the transfer learning model. OutputDir is the directory to write the model checkpoints and model predictions. LoggingDir is the directory for saving logs. LoggingStrategy is the strategy for logging the training information. No means no logging for the training. Epoch means logging at the end of each epoch. Steps means logging at the end of each logging steps. Logging steps is the number of steps between two logs. The default is 500. NumTrainEpochs is the total number of training epochs. The default value is 3. Per device train batch size is the batch size per GPU, TPU core, CPU for training. The default value is 8. Per device eval batch size is the batch size per GPU, TPU core, CPU for evaluation. The default value is 8. Learning rate is the initial learning rate for Atom W Optimizer. The default value is 5e to the power of negative 5. Seed is for reproducibility. Save strategy is the strategy for saving the checkpoint during training. No means do not save during training. Epoch means saving at the end of each epoch. Steps means saving at the end of each save steps. Steps is the default value. Save steps is the number of steps before two checkpoint saves. The default value is 500. Evaluation strategy is the strategy for evaluation during training. It's helpful for us to monitor the model performance during model fine-tuning. No means no evaluation during training. Epoch means evaluating at the end of each epoch and the evaluation results will be printed out at the end of each epoch. Steps means evaluating and reporting at the end of each eval steps. No is the default value. Eval steps is the number of steps between two evaluations if evaluation strategy equals steps. It defaults to the same value as logging steps if not set. Load best model at end equals true indicates that the best model will be loaded at the end of the training. The default is false. When it is set to true, the save strategy and evaluation strategy must be the same. When both arguments are steps, the value of save steps needs to be a round multiple of the value of eval steps. In step 8, we will set the evaluation metric because Hugging Face Trainer does not evaluate the model performance automatically during the training process. Hugging Face has an evaluate library with over 100 evaluation modules. We can see the list of all the modules using evaluate. List evaluation modules. Since our dataset is highly balanced, we will use accuracy as the evaluation metric. It can be loaded using evaluate.load. After getting predictions from the model, the metric is computed using metric. Compute. In step 9, we will train the model using the transformer trainer. Model is the model for training, evaluation, or prediction by the trainer. Args takes the arguments for tweaking the trainer. It defaults to the instance of training arguments. Train dataset is the training dataset name. If the dataset is in dataset format, the unused columns will be automatically ignored. In our training dataset, index level 0 and review are not used by the model, so they are ignored. Eval dataset is the evaluation dataset name. Similar to the train dataset, the unused columns will be automatically ignored for the dataset format. Compute metrics takes the function for calculating evaluation metrics. Callbacks takes a list of callbacks to customize the training loop. Early stopping callback stops the training by early stopping patients for the evaluation calls. There is no practical need to use early stopping because there are only two epochs for the model. It is included as an example code reference. We can see that the accuracy is above 90% in just two epochs. In step 10, we will talk about how to make predictions using the Hugging Face Transformer Trainer model. Passing the tokenized dataset to the .predict method, we get the predictions for the customized transfer learning sentiment model. We can see that the prediction results contain multiple pieces of information. NumExamples equals 200 indicates that there are 200 reviews in the testing dataset. Batch size equals 4 means that 4 reviews are processed each time. Under prediction output, predictions has the logits for each class. Logit is the last layer of the neural network before softmax is applied. Label IDs has the actual labels. Please note that it is not predicted labels although it is under the prediction output. We need to calculate the predicted labels based on the logit values. Under metrics there is information about the testing predictions. Test loss is the loss for the testing dataset. Test accuracy is the percentage of correct predictions. Test runtime is the runtime for testing. Test samples per second is the number of samples the model can process in 1 second. Test steps per second is the number of steps the model can process in 1 second. The predicted logits for the transfer learning text classification model can be extracted using dot predictions. We can see that the prediction has two columns. The first column is the predicted logit for label 0 and the second column is the predicted logit for label 1. Logit values do not sum up to 1. To get the predicted probabilities, we need to apply softmax on the predicted logit values. After applying softmax, we can see that the predicted probability for each review sums up to 1. To get the predicted labels, argmax is used to return the index of the maximum probability for each review, which corresponds to the labels of zeros and ones. The actual labels can be extracted using y-test predict. Label IDs. In step 11, we will make the transfer learning text classification model performance evaluation. Trainer.evaluate is a quick way to get the loss and the accuracy of the testing dataset. We can see that the model has a loss of 0.28 and an accuracy of 91.5%. To calculate more model performance metrics, we can use evaluate.load to load the metrics of interest. The results show that the testing dataset has an F1 value of 0.91 and a recall value of 0.89. In step 12, we will talk about how to save the model and reload it for prediction. Tokenizer.save pretrained saves the tokenizer information to the drive and model.save model saves the model to the drive. We can load the saved tokenizer later using autotokenizer.fromPretrained and load the saved model using automodelforsequenceclassification.fromPretrained. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about natural language processing, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.